Canva just wrapped up its biggest annual event, Canva Create, and as usual, they announced some pretty exciting new features and a lot of really nice updates. But by now, you know that I like to cut through the hype and look at what's actually going to make a difference to our lives day to day. So in this video, I'm going to cover what I think are the two most powerful announcements from Canva Create 2025, four underrated features that I know will actually make a difference, and one surprise launch that opens up a whole world of creative possibilities. So let's do this. The first and biggest launch from Canva Create was the announcement of Visual Suite 2.0. Now, from a practical point of view, this is probably the most exciting announcement we've had for a long while. With Visual Suite 2.0, you can now create different design types. So for example, a document, a social post, vertical video, whiteboard, even a web page, all in a single Canva design file. It works just like adding a new page, except you can now add a new design type right next to the previous one. Each page can be a completely different size and format. If, for example, you're creating weekly content, so say you have a YouTube thumbnail for your video, a blog post to accompany it, an Instagram post to announce it, and a TikTok with a clip from it. Imagine doing all of that in one Canva file, using one template that you previously created to stay on brand. It keeps everything consistent, and it's going to make it so easy to manage designs in your dashboard. One design file in the dashboard for every week, instead of five separate ones in completely different sizes. Next up is Canva Sheets. Yes, I know it's a spreadsheet tool, but if you're like me and you usually break out into a cold sweat when you hear the word spreadsheet, I've got good news. This is more like the stylish love child of Google Sheets and Airtable, and it will help up-level a whole load of Canva's existing capabilities. It's specifically designed to be more visual and interactive, and it basically supercharges features like bulk create. For example, now you'll be able to resize multiple different designs all at once. You can create more advanced and clickable charts and graphs. Plus, and this is what I find really exciting, you can use plain language to write formulas and get insights with the help of the integrated AI. And the updated charts tool also means that you can finally make all this data look good. Honestly, I didn't expect to be excited by anything that said spreadsheets, but I'm really looking forward to exploring, I guess, the possibilities for this so that I can use it to up-level my creative workflow and make the most out of those other Canva tools. Now onto the smaller features that weren't given much airtime, but I know will be seriously helpful. Our favorite tool, the background remover, now has a big sister on steroids. Canva's AI can now let you replace a background by just typing a prompt, and it's surprisingly good. What I especially love is that you have the option to refine the lighting so that your original foreground image fits a little better with the new background. It's not super perfect, but it's really effective and so easy to use. Canva's image editing tools have also had a bit of a subtle glow up. So alongside the existing magic tools that we're used to by now, you can now tweak and retouch images a little more easily and more subtly. And even better, you can edit images that you've uploaded outside a design and save them as a new version ready to use. I did create a video about image editing a little while ago, which you can watch up here, and takes you through some of these tools. Captions have had a much requested update. They now come with the animation option that lets you highlight words as you speak. So if you've watched my captions video, the basic functions are just the same. This is just with a great little upgrade to highlight what you're talking about and make it feel more on brand and more in touch with the types of videos we see on TikTok and on Instagram. Now, this one was barely mentioned, but I actually think it's a big step up. Canva websites can now have multiple pages, and you can have multiple sections within a single page with automatic navigation for all of it. Now, I think this simple change will make Canva websites way more flexible and more usable for more serious projects. There are also some really nice quality of life tweaks that were announced, like some new photo animations, kerning controls, which is just a simplified version of professional tools that refine the spacing between letters in a word to make it look and read better. You can easily create subscript or superscript options for your text, and even ligatures if your font supports them. There's also text highlights in a doc now, and a load more of other stuff. I'll actually drop a link in the description so you can check out the full list, and you can also watch the keynote if you have some time and you fancy geeking out on Canva. Canva AI has also been updated and is now baked right into the homepage. So you can still search for new templates or for your own designs, but you now also have the option with just single click to ask Canva to design something for you. It basically replaces the magic design tool that we've seen before, but I have to be honest, it's definitely not there yet. The demo from Canva is a little shady because it made it look like it would pull your brand styles and create cohesive options of brilliant designs ready to use. In reality, it's really hit and miss. The styles aren't applied consistently from your brand, and it's actually harder to refine than before because the filter options have been removed. What is nice is how easily you can just start editing a suggested design if there is one that you like. That part flows super well. But as with a lot of these AI tools, I do feel it's a little more hype than heart, to be honest, and I actually got way better results just using the template search function to find things that work for my brand. Speaking of Canva AI, now this caught my attention. Canva announced Canva Code, an AI tool that writes all the code and creates prototypes for interactive digital ideas right inside Canva, all just based on your prompt. Now, it's not as advanced as something like Bolt or Lovable, which are external apps, but it is ridiculously easy to use. So I asked it to create an interactive website that suggests appropriate font pairings for your brand based on style keywords. And it built this in under 3 minutes. And I could now choose to publish this as a Canva website, and anyone can access it and use it with the link. There is real potential here for creative tools and games and interactive apps. I mean, you name it. I think this will get a lot of playtime to start with. But one thing to note is that anything you create or build on it will have to stay hosted on Canva. But it still could be so useful, and you could get so creative with it. In all honesty, I would have loved to see some more simple updates, so to things like Canva's video editor and website builder. But overall, there is a lot to be excited about. AI is definitely still Canva's big focus, but honestly, it's the less gimmicky stuff that I think will make the biggest impact to us day to day. The upgrades to the tools that we already use daily are what really level up our workflow and our process. And I have to be honest, I personally still have some serious concerns about things like the environmental impact of these very AI-intensive tools. Now remember, you don't need to master everything in Canva immediately, especially all the new stuff. Focus on the tools that help you move your business forward right now. And the rest of it you can learn as you go or as you have time. I would love to hear what you think. Please drop a comment and let me know what your highlight from Canva Create was from these announcements, and also what you think is missing, what you'd like to see that they haven't already announced. Oh, and if you don't have access to these updates yet, hopefully you won't have to wait too long. Canva has said that they will be rolling these out to everyone in the coming weeks. So I will let you know if I have any further updates on that. Okay, folks, take care of yourselves, be kind to each other, and keep creating more joy out there.